नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी स्टार्ट स्टैंडर्ड 7th सोशल साइंस रिवीजन वर्क।
इन दिस वीडियो वी स्टार्ट अवर रिवीजन विथ आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन। वी ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड मोर क्वेश्चन एंड नाउ टू कंटिन्यू अवर रिवीजन वी अगेन वी स्टार्ट विथ आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन। सो नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज राइट ए नोट ऑन द लिटरेचर इन द रैंक ऑफ किंग हर्षवर्धन। सो वी हैव टू राइट अबाउट किंग हर्षवर्धन टाइम इन दिस रीजन व्हाट इज अबाउट द लिटरेचर। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी कैन से किंग हर्षवर्धन वॉज अ ग्रेट लवर ऑफ आर्ट्स एंड लिटरेचर। सो किंग हर्षवर्धन हिमसेल्फ वॉज द लवर ऑफ आर्ट एंड लिटरेचर। He also interested in literature. So second number is Bhanuvar was a gem. Gem means precious stone. So Bhanuvar was a precious stone in his court. So in King Harshvardhan kingdom, Bhanuvar was a precious stone means he was very famous hero in his time and he was in the kingdom of Harshvardhan. So Bhanuvar was a gem in the court of king. He was great poet and writer. So who was Bhanuvar? Bhanuvar was a great poet and great writer. Now next one is Bhanuvar composed two famous work. Why he is very famous? Because Bhanuvar himself composed two famous work in Sanskrit language. Which are they? They are Harshcharita, a biography of King Harshvardhan. Biography means a person's life about life story. So that one is known as biography. So Bhanuvar wrote two famous work in Sanskrit. First one is Harshcharita. It is related to King Harshvardhan and it is personal life of King Harshvardhan. So that why it is known as the biography of King Harshvardhan. And second famous thing was Kadambari. And third one is King Harshcharita covers a lot about the life of great King Harshvardhan. And in Harshcharita, it was a biography of King Harshvardhan. It is related about the lot of information we can get from the great King Harshvardhan. Now next point is King Harshvardhan was also a great writer himself. So it means King Harshvardhan can also write himself. So he was also himself a great writer. He also wrote many plays. So King Harshvardhan himself was a great writer. That's why he was the lover of arts and literature. Which type of plays he wrote? King Harshvardhan wrote three plays. Which are they? First one Nagananda, second is Ratnavali, and third one is Priyadarshika. So how we can come to know Harshvardhan was a great literature in his time? So first we again repeated King Harshvardhan himself, he was the lover of art and literature. Second thing, Bhanuvar was the gem. Gem means precious stone. Means he is very precious in kingdom of King Harshvardhan. So Bhanuvar was the precious stone in his court. Means kingdom of King Harshvardhan. He was a great poet. Bhanuvar was a great poet and writer. Bhanuvar composed two Sanskrit work in Sanskrit language. Two work was there. First one is biography of King Harshvardhan. It is known as Harshcharita. And second is Kadambari. And King Harshvardhan himself a great writer. King Harshvardhan wrote himself, he wrote three plays, Nagananda, Ratnavali and Priyadarshita. Now our next question is, over which region did Pulkesi II rule? Here we are talking about Pulkesi II. Over which region did Pulkesi II rule? And this question also asked like this, what was the contribution of Pulkesi II in expanding his territories? Territories means border. How Pulkesi II contribute means to give a part of life to make expand his border, territories. So what was the contribution of Pulkesi II in expanding his territories? So answer is Pulkesi II. First we are talking about Pulkesi II. So Pulkesi II was a virtuous king. Virtuous king means very successful or excellent character person. So Pulkesi II was an excellent character king. Ruled over South India, and minimum he ruled in South India around 30 years. So first we can write Pulkesi II, the virtuous king, and ruled over South India for almost 30 years. Second, he was a majestic king. Majestic king means having a quality of royalty, means very status, good status and very powerful person. So he was means Pulkesi II was a very powerful person, valiant means courageous and brave soldier. Because of Pulkesi II was a brave and character person, so that's why he made his territories very big. He expanded his territories. Third one, he had won many battles because he was very powerful and brave soldier. That's why he defeated other king in the battle. So that's why he had won many battles. Next one is, first he won Lath, where it is located in South Gujarat. So first he was the winner of Lath. It is in South Gujarat. And get means get victory over Gurjar in North Gujarat. So overall he was the victorious. He become the victory of Gujarat. Then next he also conquered Vengi states. Where it is located? It is located between rivers Krishna and Godavari. So first he was the winner of Lath. It is located in South Gujarat, and then also in Gurjar, means it is in also North Gujarat. So all over Gujarat, most of he was the winner. And then he also won Andhra Pradesh. Thus Pulkesi II expand the territories of kingdom to great extent. So in short we can say Pulkesi II himself, very excellent king, he was very good character and he ruled over in South India around 30 years. He was majestic king, means he was very powerful, brave and very courageous soldier. He had won many battles because he was very powerful and he is also good soldier. So first he was winner in South Gujarat, then he also made his territories in North South Gujarat. So where it is? It is in Gurjar. In Gurjar also, in North Gujarat, he also become the winner. Then he also conquered Vengi. And where it is located? Vengi is located between the river Krishna and Godavari. He also won Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh, it is also in South India. So thus we can say that Pulkesi II expanded the territories of his kingdom to a great extent.
Thank you for joining us.